numbers that matter today, proof that sometimes what glitters can also be gold. It's $57 million. The personal finance firm Wallet Hub estimates that's how much it costs to organize the annual Academy Awards. The hefty price tag is expected for Hollywood's biggest night, as costs range from goodie bags for winners to paying who's hosting the Oscars. And while there's no cash prize for winning an Oscar, Wallet Hub says winners of the Best Actor and Best Actress awards can see their pay in their next project jump by 20%. CNBC meanwhile reports those who fail to bring home an award still get a consolation prize, a gift bag worth over $180,000. And for the supposed return of investment, the Oscars bring in $120 million in ad revenue for ABC, the network that aired the awards. Senator Risa Ontiveros slams troubled televangelist Apollo Quiboloy for making numerous demands for his appearance before a Senate inquiry into his alleged crimes. Ontiveros, who is leading the Senate investigation, said Quiboloy has listed 17 conditions, including an all-expense-paid trip with hotel booking for him and his entourage.
Eh, yung mga resource persons nga sa hearing ay hindi pinapayagang i-interpellate ang isa't isa. Ang mga miyembro lang ng Senado ang nagtatanong sa resource persons. At lalong walang resource person na nagtatanong o nagko-cross-examine sa chair. At madalas, in the interest of time, kami mismong mga kapo-senador ay nag-o-observe ng time limit ayon sa facilitation ng chair. Ito sila, no time limit. So, talaga, out of this world.
Ontiveros has cited Quiboloy in contempt for snubbing the hearings, a move that is being blocked by at least four senators. Meanwhile, Senator Robin Hood Padilla, who is trying to block the possible Senate arrest order for Quiboloy, has filed a resolution to investigate the National Telecommunication Commission's indefinite suspension of Quiboloy's media arm, SMNI. Padilla called the suspension of SMNI baseless and a denial of due process. 11 Filipino crew members of a ship that was recently attacked by Houthi rebels set to arrive home tomorrow. They are part of the crew of the MV True Confidence, a bulk carrier that suffered a missile attack in the Gulf of Aden. The attack killed three crew members, including two Filipinos, of the Barbados-flagged vessel. It was the Houthis' first fatal strike since it began attacking commercial ships in response to the Israel-Hamas war in Gaza.
The plenary debates over the resolution seeking to amend economic provisions in the Philippine Constitution set to begin today. This comes a week after the House Committee of the Whole approved resolutions of both houses number 7 without amendments. Senior Deputy Speaker Aurelio Gonzalez, one of the main authors of RBH 7, is confident the lower chamber can approve all of the proposed amendments on third and final reading before the Holy Week break.
The position of the commission is that
diferensya palagay ko wala na before the Lenten recess dito sa ating House of Representatives, we can approve that on third and final reading next week. Hopefully by Monday, si Presidente, ang tawag natin dyan, best salesman ng Pilipinas. Kasi based on the investments and pledges he has collected from different trips abroad. Kaya kailangan po natin itong economic cha-cha para lalong mapaganda, lumawig ang ating ekonomiya sa ating bansa.
But another congressman questions the legality of the approval procedure for the resolution.
Sa bahagi po natin sa kabataan, kukwestiyonin natin ang nangyayari based on two points. Sa procedure at sa nilalaman nito. Kasi po sa procedure pa lang, parang nagsasend kami ng oras. Kasi ang proseso na ginagawa namin para baguhin ang konstitusyon, wala po yan sa mismong konstitusyon natin. Ibig sabihin po, pwede talaga makwestiyon na illegal yung aming ginagawa. Kasi ang pwede nang gawin namin ay kung yung tinatawag po constituent assembly, dapat po talaga nasa iisang venue ang Senado tsaka ang Kamara. Kasi hindi naman po pwedeng Kamara lang na hindi kasama ang Senado. So, dun pa lang sablay na eh, ang procedure.
Lawmakers have been deliberating the renewed push for charter change that would ease foreign ownership restrictions in education, public utilities, and advertising.